My fellow kindred, my apologies for disrupting any business or interfering with prior engagements you may have had this evening. It's unfortunate that the affair that gathers us together tonight is a troubling one. We are here because the laws that bind our society, the laws that are the fabric of our existence, have been broken. As prince, I am within my rights to grant or deny the kindred of this city the privilege of siring. Many of you have come to me seeking permission, and I have endorsed some of these requests. However, the accused that sits before you tonight was not refused permission. Indeed, my permission was never sought at all. They were caught shortly after the embrace of this child. It pains me to announce the sentence, as up to tonight I considered the accused a loyal and upstanding member of our organization. But as some of you may know, the penalty for this transgression is death. Know that I am no more adjudicator than I am a servant to the law that governs us all. Let tonight's proceedings serve as a reminder to our community that we must adhere to the code that binds our society, lest we endanger all of our blood. Forgive me. Let the penalty commence. Which leads to the fate of the ill-begotten progeny. Without a sire, most child are doomed to walk the earth never knowing their place, their responsibility, and most importantly, the laws they must obey. Therefore, I have decided that...
This is bullshit!
If Mr. Rodriguez would let me finish, I have decided to let this kindred live. They shall be instructed in the ways of our kind and be granted the same rights. Let no one say I am unsympathetic to the plights and causes of this community. I thank you all for attending these proceedings, and I hope their significance is not lost. Good evening. Your sire, tragic, my apologies. But you see, there is a strict code of conduct that all of us must adhere to if we wish to survive. When anyone breaks these laws, they undermine the well-worn fabric of our centuries-old society. Understand my predicament. Allowing you to live makes me directly responsible for your subsequent behavior. So, what I'm offering is not generosity, but the opportunity to transcend the fate woven by your sire. This is your trial. You will be brought to Santa Monica. There you will meet an agent by the name of Mercurio. He will provide the details of your labor. I've shown you great clemency. Prove it was more than a wasted gesture, fledgling. Don't come back until you do. Good evening.
Thank you.
Bloolines, let me show you the ropes.
Wait a sec.
I'm Jack. What's important is I'm offering help. You make it back from Santa Monica with your hide and we'll trade life stories, okay? Till then, I got about this much time. You in or out? Youngsters these days. Well, your funeral, kiddo. But keep a couple things in mind before you go. Now, these lessons aren't just for your benefit, so listen up. First, the masquerade. You're gonna hear a lot about this, so let me sum up real quick. Sure, you're a vampire. Great. Keep it to yourself, okay? It's easier that way, trust me. That's the masquerade. Keeping vampire secrets secret. Easy, right? Easy peasy. Now, if you violate the masquerade, if you run around spooking humans or whatever, you make things harder on all of us. Then all of us get pissed off and we come after you. You end up like your sire there, staked and bait. Comprende, kiddo? Right on. Next, humanity. Being a vampire isn't the end of the road. You think life was hard? Just wait. Now you're half beast, half man, and it ain't quite an easy fit. You're gonna be fighting that beast for the rest of your days every time you get into it. Whenever you kill an innocent, you feed the beast a little more. And it grows a little stronger. After a while, the beast can take over and you'll go wild and have to be put down like a rabid dog. So, you know, fight it. Don't be a homicidal maniac. That'll help with the masquerade, too. See how it all comes together? Ain't that nice? Now, with all that said, you still have to keep your ass alive. For that, you're gonna have to feed. That's a little blood sound, kiddo. Imagine you're feeling that thirst right about now, huh? Get it where you can, however you can. Just remember the first two lessons. Don't let anyone else see you feeding. They'll flip out and cause you to break the masquerade and cause some bigger, badder vampire to come stomp a mud hole in your ass. Also, drink deep, but don't drain them dry. See, that's giving in to the beast. You do that, you lose a grip on your humanity and you lose control. There we go again. It all fits together. Evil. Can you dig it? Righteous. Now, ship off like a good little soldier. If you pull this off, come downtown to the last round and I'll tell you how jacked this whole situation is. Until then, good luck. Or maybe I should just say, nice knowing you, kiddo.
I have. If you're new to town or just new to this whole radio thing, you're listening to The Dead of Night. The only girl who will spend the night with you and leave first thing in the morning, guaranteed. Well, looks like the boards are lighting up. Aren't I the popular one? Let's see, eeny, meeny, miny, moe, who will be the lucky... Caller, you've got the first shot at Deb tonight. So, who do I have the pleasure of speaking to?
Hi, Deb. This is, Vigo.
Vigo? So, Vigo, why are you up so late?
I'm working a late shift here at the... Club.
How many boats do you own, Vigo?
Two. Actually, three. One is in the shop.
I used to do a little yachting myself. What brand of yacht do you have?
You probably wouldn't know the brand. I bought them in Italy.
Ah, like that, yeah, bella. Parlate italiano?
Yes.
Arrivederci, Vigo. Caller two, you're on The Deb of Night. Be gentle.
Hi, Gip.
Hello, caller.
Hi, Gip.
Is tonight a rerun?
Yep.
Caller number three, what's keeping you up tonight?
Deb, listen to me, Deb. They're at it again and people have got to know. They've got to know because they don't know. They won't report this stuff on the news because they own the news.
Hello, Gomez. What's the latest conspiracy?
Conspiracy? This goes beyond conspiracy, okay? There's no word for something as devious and secret as this, you understand? People need to hear this. They need to know the real story.
You've got our undivided attention.
All right. As we all know, the Americans established a moon base back in the late 70s. That's no secret. What most people don't know is that they've been conducting a dig, not for resources, but for artifacts.
I see.
Well, it's no coincidence that the Chinese have started conducting space missions. You know, the Americans in the 50s.
Fascinating.
The American government's been putting more money into space. Don't you see what's happening? I can't believe I'm the only one that's figured it out. Am I the only person alive that can see what's going on? It's because the Andromedans and the Betas are going to be fighting their war in this galaxy through us, Dad. And the American people, the people of Earth, you people, come out of the desert.
Well, this girl's got to pay her bills, so it's time for a few commercials. But don't...
You got some change, mister? Nothing. Just waiting for a friend to get off work. He's a police officer. Old army buddy. He should be bringing his dog as well. It's a Rottweiler. Wonderful attack dogs they are. Afraid I'm a little short on cash right now. I'm so sorry. I'm happily married. To my work, and I have a wife too.
Those mothers ripped me off. I'm dying here. Yeah. You looking for the astrolite? I can feel a draft on my fucking insides. They shanked me, the bastards. The blood ain't working no more. My head, it feels cracked. Oh, I think my eyes popped. What is this lump? Is this my rib? Oh, holy shit. My rib is poking through my side? Oh, I'm all numb. You gotta look and tell me. Goddamn chemist. Can't trust any operators in L.A. I verified him. Organization seem reliable. Guy mixes up speed. His crew sells it. Occasionally does explosives. I set up a drop. I show up at the beach with the money, right? Four of these guys, they come out of nowhere. Junkie pricks, hit me with a bat. It feels like I got a friggin' horse kicking it. Those cocksuckers beat me rotten, left me for a stiff. Had to crawl to my car, call my ass up here. The vamp blood's the only thing holding me together. But shit, they got the money, they got the astrolite. You can't tell anybody. Nobody can know I blew it. Promise me. If they find out I'm a dead man. With you types, I screw up once and it's over. You hear me? I'm a goddamn memory. Those small-time sons of bitches live out in a dump on the beach. Four or five of them. The one's got the explosives is Dennis. Got my money too, that prick.
Laying in a pool in my own blood and you want friggin' directions. Right, all right. Down the street, in the parking garage, stairs down to the beach, on the right. Those better not be some of my last words.
You gotta get it back from him. Maybe reason with him, maybe break in, I don't know. I want to kill him. Do whatever you people do. I blew it, I know. Yeah, if you could... Oh, something just started leaking. I need something for the pain.
One more thing. About the deal. I mean it. You tell anyone about this, I'm dead. I'm begging you. I got a way of getting people what they need. You don't say anything, I can help you out.
That's the kind of thing that makes you lose your faith in humanity.
I gotta say, it's the second worst thing I've ever seen.
Up there. Through that chain link gate and up those stairs. Those men you are looking for. Never mind. You wouldn't understand.
Help you? Oh, really? You call ahead? The men expecting you? Because he didn't tell me to expect anybody.
You just made my night, asshole.
Hey, stop right now.
Thank you.
Easy. No, what? No.
Evening. It's nothing. No. I have a speech problem. Sorry.
Like I've told you types about 1,000 times now. We know we can't hunt round here, all right? We're minding our own business. No reason to hassle the weaklings. You mean you ain't here to run us off? We're getting pretty sick of it. Someone's sighting domain, or in the worst case, is hunting us for sport. We all seem to have come down with the same disease. Oh, who am I kidding? We're a bad horror show, right? We seem to be the runts, the mistakes. You types call us thin bloods. I say we're all equally screwed. I'm damned if I know. Well, I know you don't want to be one. You seem to be in the loop. You tell me. I've heard all that before, and I still don't know what the hell anyone's talking about. I'd like to know just what I've become. We'd all like to know just what the hell kind of devil's contract we've apparently signed. I just come to town for the surf tourney. Seems like years ago. It's, well, been about 6 months now. Every night during the finals, I used to hit the local diner after the beach parties fizzled out in the AM. That's where I met her. She had a natural beauty. Not like all the plastic dolls littering the sand. Her name was Lily. I remember introducing myself. The way she seemed grateful for the company. Well, a few nights after our meeting, we were on the beach alone. She tried to tell me what she was, but I didn't understand. And so she showed me. Furious with her when I took it all in, I cursed her and left. Never really knowing what I was. I realize now how she must have felt. So here I am now, a mystery to myself. Clinically, yes. But honestly, I don't know. I suppose I'd have moved on by now if I didn't think she'd show up one of these nights. There's a lot I've got left to say to her. That's what Lily tried to tell me. But what I don't understand are the rules and the terms and the reasons some of them are at our throats claiming we're harbingers of the apocalypse. That's what I want to know. Aye, most of them just recently arrived in LA. Got chased off by the Sabbath or some such thing from their home cities. They're more in the dark than I am. They're a good bunch, but well, they've been through a lot. You had better luck than I did. No one's been particularly friendly to me in the city. The only reason we're in Santa Monica is because we haven't been chased out yet.
Do you know who the head vampire is? If the head vampire dies, we all become human again, right?
Oh.
But, how about blood transfusions? If I get a full blood transfusion, I can become human again, right?
What?
Oh, no. There's nothing I can do?
Shh. Mayhem, bro.
Me. No, you are going to China. Why is he smiling? The father. Is it the father behind him? chased it for the one at the top of the city. On the sea. Oh, on the ground. Oh, you found it in the crypt. It's open. Oh, it's open. Oh God. Oh God. Run. I'm sorry. Sometimes I see nothing. Disregard what I say. I don't know what I'm saying. Forget what I say. Fortune is not your destiny. All of us are unfortunate. Every time I sleep, the future plays out before me. I know the ending. It will end over and over until I cease to dream. I know your questions. For $100, I'll tell you what you don't want to hear. I need money to leave this place.
Yeah? Did you waste those sons of bitches? Good. Great. Hope it was painful. Did you get my money back? Damn! I could have used that money to buy myself some new kidneys. Anyway. That astrolite? Twice as powerful as TNT. Instant demolition. Be on the other side of the world when you engage that timer. You need to make someplace disappear. A warehouse. Looks to be a Sabbat interest. There's a guy. I never met him, but I heard a lot about him. His name is Tong. Bertram Tong. He's one of you types. If there's anyone who knows more than me about this city, it's him. Unfortunately, Tong's hiding out at the moment. Tong's laying low because of Therese. Therese Vorman, you know her? Anyway, word is Therese and Tong are feuding. I don't know the details. My take's that Tong thinks he's about to get whacked, so he's gone underground till Therese calls it off. If you want to put that warehouse into orbit anytime soon, you're gonna have to get Therese to call off the feud. She and her sister Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place. I try not to do business there. She's the woman around here. Power player. Nice looking broad for a dead chick, but personality like stone. Therese I don't like, but I can respect her. Jeanette's different. I don't know what to make of her. She's a little, you know, in the head. I don't know. Therese is, well, like you. And I would think so's Jeanette. But I hear rumors about her. Right. You're straight off the bus. Once a month I get fed vampire blood. Heals me faster. Makes me stronger than a normal human. I don't age. By looking at me, you wouldn't realize it, but I'm almost 60.
What do we have here? Another scrumptious young plaything straight out of life and into my club? You smell new, little boy. Like fabric softener dew on freshly mowed astroturf. I'm not frightening you, am I, duckling? I'm the finger down your spine when all the lights are out. I'm the name on all the men's room walls. When I pout, the whole world tries to make me smile. And everyone always wants to know who is that girl. I am Jeanette. And this bit of chaos crammed in a certifiable giggle is my club. I just love to give you funny feelings all night, sweetheart, but I really must trouble with some business. We'll reunite Sweden soon, I promise.
Some free cheese.
right. Goodbye.
Please, come in. I do apologize for my sister's crassness if it made you uncomfortable. She's unabashedly scandalous, but in the club business, I suppose that kind of personality is a necessary evil. Nonsense. She's nothing but. Therese Vorman, yes. I'm the proprietor of this club, and the only person in this city whose good side it's in your best interest to stay on. What brings you to Santa Monica? Tung's exile is self-imposed, I assure you. But then, what reason would I have not to hate that loathsome Nosferatu scoundrel? Bloody Nosferatu. They're so unclean. He meddles in my affairs. He's a bad influence on my sister, and she on him. If you were in my place, would you let him compromise your authority? You most certainly would not. I'd quite like it if I never had to hear that name again. Why would I do that? Let him think I mean to kill him. That way I don't have to worry about him sabotaging everything. Do you realize how his subterfuge makes me look to the Camarilla? Tongue and his co-conspirators' actions ruined my chance at partnership in a crucial piece of property. I do have several other promising ventures, and one in particular has been, to say the least, an ordeal. I'd be willing to put the word out that my grievances with Tongue have been swept under the rug, but in return, you'll have to help me remove a particularly burdensome spirit from a property I'm looking to invest in. Rumor is that a personal item of a ghost may be used to draw it out or excise it from its haunt. While I don't put a lot of stock in hearsay, it's my last option. So I want you to go to the Ocean House Hotel, find an item of the spirits, and bring it back. Oh, I fully intend to do so. You'll find that dealing with me on the whole is appreciably more predictable than dealing with some of the egomaniacs that are my peers. So long as our business doesn't go sour, my word is gold. Before I forget, take this. The only way to reach the Ocean House this time of night is through a tunnel in the sewers. You'll need that key to open the gate for that tunnel. If you'll excuse me, I've got situations to set straight.